Well, good morning. It's Wonder of God Wednesday, and today we begin reading from the book of Daniel. Daniel is a prophetic book from the Old Testament speaking to the people of Israel while they're in exile in Babylon. It's a book with a pattern and a promise for Israel and all future generations, including us. The pattern is one of what happens to humankind when we go our own way of selfishness and self-sufficiency. The promise is how God defeats the power of selfishness and self-sufficiency, restoring us and our world into perfect love again. Daniel and his three friends are living in a foreign land, but not just that. They're living in a culture opposed to their way of life as followers of Yahweh, and they're being forced to make a choice. Are they going to compromise their devotion to Yahweh, or are they going to remain faithful? During the exile, some Israelites chose to resist their oppressors by revolting, and others gave in by adopting the Babylonian way of life. And when we face challenging circumstances of faith and culture, we might also think that these are our only two options. But you might remember in our reading from earlier this summer, the prophet Jeremiah said to do something very different and a little surprising. Said to settle in and seek the well-being of Babylon, praying to God on its behalf. This is a third way. It's not compromise or revolt. Daniel and his friends take Jeremiah's advice and lived this third way. Because of their education, they were recruited to work in the high court of Babylon, and they serve the king and even take on Babylonian names and their clothing style. At first, it may seem like they're compromising, but the book of Daniel focuses on key moments when they draw the line and choose faithfulness to God over cultural pressure. This is what happens in the famous stories of the fiery furnace and the lion's den. Daniel and his friends critique Babylon's idolatry of power, arrogance, and injustice, but they do it nonviolently by laying down their lives. And in doing so, God vindicates them, saves their lives, and sets forward an example of what it means to be faithful. So even while Daniel and his friends serve Babylon and seek its well-being, their loyalty is always to God. The way of exile is a combination of loyalty and subversion. As we ultimately seek Christ, the way to find hope in the midst of challenge is to go through it, loving enemies, seeking the best for all, but refusing to compromise God's law of love. It's what Jesus calls a narrow path, because it's not usually our default or preferred method. So I'd like to close with a modern example of what this has looked like in our culture. Consider these lesser-known words from Martin Luther King Jr. and how they resonate with the witness of Daniel and his three friends. To our most bitter opponents, we say, we shall match your capacity to inflict suffering by our capacity to endure suffering. We shall meet your physical force with our soul force. Do to us what you will, and we shall continue to love you. We cannot in all good conscience obey your unjust laws, because non-cooperation with evil is as much a moral obligation as is cooperation with good. Throw us in jail, we'll still love you. Bomb our homes, threaten our children, we will still love you. But be assured that we will wear you down by our capacity to suffer. One day we shall win freedom, but not only for ourselves. We shall so appeal to your heart and conscience that we shall win you in the process, and our victory will be a double victory. In the midst of our current challenges, I pray we can be inspired by Jeremiah, Daniel and his friends, and Martin Luther King Jr., who faithfully followed the third way of God, ultimately revealed in Christ. Have a great day.